look at Advantage Doppler 3D. Pretty dry for most of us. There are a few isolated thundershowers out there. North of Poto, east of Tallahena, west of Mena. You've been out there. You've taken that drive in the fall. Sure is beautiful, but these are weak, and they're slowly moving to the northeast. We're going to be dry tonight. You don't have to worry about your weather radio going off. Not at all. There's a little green around the metro. That's just a little ground clutter, and that happens sometimes as the temperatures fall. Taking a look outside right now, looking pretty good, Oklahoma City, kind of quiet. Everyone's home watching the game, and temperature now 71 degrees. The winds are light. They're out of the east, northeast, but south winds tomorrow, they're going to bring the humidity back. So you'll notice that by tomorrow afternoon. You're going to notice on Sunday, it's going to be air you can wear. It's going to be real, real muggy. That's going to be fuel for the storms. Evan, you're 68. Shawnee, you're 66. These are current temperatures. Goldsby, 63. El Reno, you've dropped down to 59 degrees. And off to the west, Clinton, 68. Enid, you're looking good. 66. Ponca City, can't forget about you either, at 63. Low temps for tomorrow morning, not bad. We're talking about some 50s northwest. I mean, Guymon in the 40s. The rest of us in the 60s. South winds during the overnight, about 10 to 15. The complete metro forecast for tomorrow, 63 out the door, lots of sunshine, 65 at 8 a.m. You're going out for lunch, not bad, 83, pretty comfortable. But after lunch, you walk out, here comes the heat, not too bad, we can handle that. But there's that 20% chance for thunderstorms. I'll talk risk for Saturday, because remember, this is a two-day event, okay? Saturday risk, Sunday risk. Highs on Saturday, we expect about 80 degrees this time of year for OKC. We're near 90, hotter off to the west, so mid-90s. Clinton, it'll be a little steamy there, 95. Here's the outlook for severe weather. It's a slight risk for Saturday. This is Saturday. Now, just because there's a risk of severe weather, it doesn't mean severe weather is guaranteed. That's the case for tomorrow. So the area highlighted in yellow, Enid, Oklahoma City, Stillwater, Tulsa, isolated storms, hail and wind risk. 1-inch size hail, 60-mile-per-hour winds. Here's the chance that you'd get thunderstorms, not the chance that you'd have severe weather, 20 to 30% chance. Oklahoma City places north from 3 to 10 p.m. That's the timeline for Saturday. So the takeaway, most of Saturday is dry. What about Sunday? Here's the outlook from 3 to 7 p.m. Oklahoma City west, low to moderate chances. Why not higher chances, Jonathan? Because storms will start at that time. They're going to be isolated, hence supercells. Watch what happens after 7 p.m. They're going to merge into a couple complexes, and we're going to have a big wave of rain move through. This is 7 p.m. Sunday all the way to 7 a.m. Monday. Those are really high chances of rain. This is good. Unfortunately, it comes with the risk of severe weather, but we need the rain. The risk, here's the outlook, only a slight risk right now. This could go up. Maybe it doesn't. Well, this is from the official outlook from the Storm Prediction Center for very large hail, damaging winds, and a tornado risk. This is the weather map that you should really pay attention to. Spent a lot of time building this, want to get specific. The outlook from 3 p.m. Sunday to 4 a.m. Monday initially starts northwestern Oklahoma, 3 to 7 p.m., right there, highlighted in blue. Isolated storms, tennis ball size hail, 70-mile-per-hour winds, tornadoes are possible. Now we go from isolated storms to several storms. We maintain the tennis ball hail size risk, 75-mile-per-hour winds, and tornadoes. This includes Oklahoma City. You're in blue, 7 to 10 p.m., I think there's going to be a little enhanced tornado risk during that window. We're going to track it real carefully. Trust me, our crews are already kind of geared up and ready to go. Then from 10 p.m. to 4 a.m., the area highlighting that purple, tornado risk goes down. This is good, but we have a 70-mile-per-hour wind risk, golf ball-sized hail risk. So you're going to want to keep those cars parked indoors. I don't always get to use fun weather graphics. When I do, Mom, I like to go all out. Look at all those flowers. Your Mother's Day forecast. What you need to know, the morning is dry. Enjoy brunch. 3 o'clock, you better be checking in because we're going to have those storms moving in for late. Here's the 5-day forecast. What does it look like? Red represents a risk of severe weather. That risk does go into Monday morning. Look at the trend of the temps. They go down 90, 88, 72. High storm chance Sunday night for OKC into Monday morning. Tuesday and Wednesday, we're dry. Let's add 5 days to it. The outlook, not too bad. We get a break from the heat. Your air conditioner, your electric bill will appreciate that, but boy, we need the rain. I don't know how many was that, 7 days of no rain?
Wow.
There are some rain chances there, but they're less than 20%. I don't put 10% on the extended forecast there.
Sure.
But we'll probably get enough in the next 3 days, it looks like.
A lot of rain coming in. Unfortunately, with the risk of severe weather,
right,
Sunday night and Monday, it includes also flash flooding risk, too, during the overnight.
We will watch it. We will be on top of it, Jonathan. Yes. Thank you.